ಪಂಚಕಸ್ಯ ಉತ್ತರ ಭಾಗೆ ಮಧ್ಯೆ ಶ್ರೀ ಶಂಕರ ಭಗವತ್ಪಾದಾಚಾರ್ಯಾಮಿ ಶ್ರೀ ಶಂಕರ ಭಗವತ್ಪಾದಾಚಾರ್ಯ
ಶ್ರೀ ಶಂಕರ ಭಗವತ್ಪಾದಾಚಾರ್ಯ ಆರ್ ಆದಿ ಶಂಕರ ಆಸ್ ವಿ ನೋ ಹಿಮ್ ವಾಸ್ ಬಾರ್ನ್ ಇನ್ 509 BCE. He established the Shree Kanchikamakoti Peetham as the Moolamnya Sarvajna Peetham when he was 27, exactly 2500 years ago, this 2018. Adi Shankara is perhaps the youngest of all the Acharyas being venerated for Vyasa Pooja. In the sequence of events, he is venerated immediately after the Vyasa Panchakam. Why is this? Even though his gurus Govinda Bhagavadpada and Shree Gaudapada come much later. It is said this is because he was the one to have written the most lucid and first bhashyam for the great Brahma Sutra. The Brahma Sutra was authored by Shree Vedavyasa. It is also said that Vyasa and Shankara Bhagavadpadacharya were none other than Vishnu and Shiva themselves. Vishnu took the rupam of Shree Vedavyasa, as we know from the Vishnu Sahasranamam. Vyasaya Vishnu Rupaya Vyasa Rupaya Vishnave. This avataram of Vishnu, Shree Vedavyasa, wrote the Brahma Sutram, a complex and beautiful treatise that explains the essence of Atmajnanam. Shiva took the rupam of Shankara Bhagavadpadacharya to write the Bhashyam for this extremely great and complex treatise. Together, they gave us the gift of Atmajnanam. Acharyal's Ashtotram reveals his accomplishments.
ಆಚಾರ್ಯಸ್ಯ ಪುರತಃ Om Shree Padmapādācharya Yonaha Shree Padmapādācharya Yayami Shree Padmapādācharya Avarami.
Shree Padmapāda was Ācharyal's first disciple. His name was Sanandana. However, he got to be called Padmapāda when his guru called him from the other bank of a furiously flowing Ganga. Sanandana was the only one who did not hesitate to run across. Miraculously, strong lotuses sprung up from underneath the waters and supported Sanandana's feet as he ran to his guru. The guru was extremely pleased. Sanandana then came to be called Padmapāda. A Kapalika once wanted to take Shree Ādi Shankara Bhagavadpādācharya's head for his sacrificial purposes. Ācharyal was in deep penance. Padmapāda realized that the Kapalika was up to no good. He invoked Shree Narasimha and took the form of Narasimha and tore the Kapalika apart, saving his guru's life. Sureshvarācharya, formerly Mandana Mishra of Mahishmati in Bihar, was a Mimamsa scholar. He and his wife were known for their great scholarship. His wife, Ubhaya Bharati, was supposed to be none other than an incarnation of the goddess Saraswati. Mandana Mishra and his wife focused on Purva Mimamsa. Shree Mandana Mishra's guru was Kumarila Bhattar. When Adi Shankara went to meet Kumarila Bhattar, he was told that he should debate with his sishya, Mandana Mishra. When asked where he could find Mandana Mishra, he was told, "There will be a home at whose gates there are a number of caged parrots discussing abstract topics like do the Vedas have self-validity or do they depend on some external authority for their validity? Are karmas capable of yielding their fruits directly or do they require the intervention of God? Is the world eternal or is it a mere appearance? Where you find the caged parrots discussing such abstruse philosophical problems, you will know that you have reached Mandana's place." Thus it is known that Mandana Mishra was not only a scholar But there were such high philosophical discussions that happened at his place that even the parrots would quote it. Bandana Mishra was already a very elderly gentleman. He lived around the 5th century BCE, that is to say, in the 500s BCE. As he was much older than Adi Shankara, he was also very dismissive of the young boy. He was also extremely arrogant that he could not be surpassed in debate. When Adi Shankara invited him for a debate, his terms were such that if he should win, Shankara should give up his sannyasi status. If he should lose, he himself will surrender and become a sannyasi, giving up his grihastha position. Vandana Mishra's wife, Bharati, became the adjudicator as she herself was so learned. It turns out that Vandana Mishra lost the debate to Shankara. Bharati, not willing to give up her married status so easily, asked Shankara to debate her in his stead. Shankara did so and he won both the debates. At the end of it, Vandana Mishra became Shankara's disciple. He was called Sureshvarācharya. Sureshvarācharya lived in Kanchipuram, became the second Pithadipati of the Shri Kanchikamakoti Pitham, a regent to the second Ācharya, Shri Sarvajñātmendriya Saraswati Shankaracharya Swami. His Adhishtanam continues to remain at the Shri Kanchikamakoti Pitham. Once when Shree Ādi Shankara Bhagavadpādācharya was going through Udupi district, there he went to Kolluru, where the famous Shree Mookambika temple is. From Kolluru, he went to a village called Shree Bali. Shree Bali, now called Shivalli, was a place where there were about 2000 Brahmanas who did Agnihotram. One of those very learned men was a man called Prabhakara. Shree Prabhakara had a son who was considered quite the idiot. He would not speak. His Upanayanam was performed, but he was not interested in learning the Veda. Shree Prabhakara, coming from such a scholarly family, was naturally extremely concerned about the state of his son. When Shree Ādi Shankara Bhagavadpādācharya came to his place, Shree Bali, Prabhakara took his son to Ādi Shankara. He asked for blessings. Ādi Shankara addressed the young boy and asked him, "Who are you?" The boy replied in 12 verses, much to the astonishment of everyone present. The boy described himself as none other than Paramatman. He had already identified himself with the divine as per Advaitic philosophy. This concept, which is so difficult for most people to grasp, was as easy for this little child as one holding an amala, a gooseberry, in their hand. Seeing this, Shree Ādi Shankara named him Hastāmalakā and he took him on as a disciple. Shree Hastāmalakar became the first Pithadipati of the Dwaraka Pitham.
Yeah, let's see. Shree Thotakācharya Dhyanagami Shree Thotakācharya Dhyanagami Shree Thotakācharya Dhyanagami.
Of the four disciples of Shree Ādi Shankara Bhagavadpādācharya, Giri, a young boy, was more interested in serving his guru. He didn't appear to have the aptitude for lessons. He was in fact an object of ridicule for his peers. Shree Padmapādar once told Ācharya, waiting for Giri would be useless. One might as well teach the wall. The wall might be able to grasp the material much faster. Ācharyal, feeling immense compassion for Giri, who was so dedicated to the service of his guru, conferred upon him the knowledge of all the shastras by his grace. Upon completing his chore, Giri walked back towards where the others were sitting with the Ācharya, and from his mouth emanated 8 beautiful verses in the complex Thotaka meter. Because this Ashtakam was so complicated and yet so divine, Giri was nicknamed Thotakācharya after his Thotakashtakam. Thotakācharya became the first Pithadipati of the Joshirmath Matham of Shree Ādi Shankara Bhagavadpādācharya. As he approached Shankara, Giri chanted the Thotakashtakam, pleading, O Shankara, you who are the repository of the Veda and the Upanishads, the ocean of knowledge, protect me. I meditate upon your lotus feet in my heart. He says that my heart is afflicted by the misery of birth and death. Make me the knower of truth. You who are Lord Shiva himself, who has the bull for his flag, please be my refuge. With the pooja to Thotakācharya, the Ācharya Panchakam is completed.